So the marketing of this movie is telling us that we cannot miss the climax of this franchise. But let's face it, the franchise busted its nut a long time ago. 50 Shades Freed is directed by James Foley and it stars Dakota Johnson and Jamie Dornan. Anastasia Steele is now Anastasia Gray as she finally marries the love of her life, Christian Gray, the multi-billionaire sex freak. After a lovely wedding and honeymoon, they come back to the normal stuff like work and sex and play and sex and family and sex. But Anastasia now has other things on her mind, like children. Can she convince Christian to be a lovely, great, supportive father? Oh yeah, and by the way, there's a crazy stalker trying to kill them both. You see how I explained the plot of this movie? Yeah, that's exactly how this movie plays out. A whole bunch of just drama that doesn't really matter. We never really get to see the characters grow or change, really, not at all. It all gets boring, bland, and repetitive, and since the people that are making this movie know this, they just randomly throw this like little bit of tension from this character that doesn't really matter much. And for the cinephiles out there, yeah, James Foley is directing this movie, Mr. Glengarry Glen Ross, but let me tell you that everybody is in here for the paycheck. Universal, the author's husband, who's also the writer, the actors, the marketing, everybody in this movie is just here for the cash. So no one's really just trying 100%. And the best example of somebody not trying 100% is Jamie Dornan. He is sleepwalking through this goddamn movie. While Dakota Johnson at least tries to be charming and funny and bring life to these scenes that are so cringe-inducingly bad, Jamie Dornan just plays it as bland and as non-expressive as possible. This dude comes with no emotion. Oh yes. You will listen to me. I'm done. And while the fans already know why they loved the book in the first place, the sex here is nothing to brag about. By this being the third movie, they already know that there is nothing special about the sex that's going to be portrayed on screen. There was nothing crazy in the first one, nor the second one, and they don't change anything here. It's actually the most blandest and just lamest sex scenes that I've ever seen in my life. Titanic, which is PG-13, has steamier sex scenes than all these three movies combined. A Rihanna music video is sexier than this shit. So it comes as no surprise to anybody when we just see them having just lame sex that just feels boring, almost like they've already been married for 10 years and they don't know how to spice up their life. Watching this franchise from the first to the third one, I always wonder what would it be like if they had somebody like Paul Verhoeven making these franchise movies. Paul Verhoeven always brought the heat when it comes to these sex scenes back in the 90s and the 80s, saying he did that foreign language film L. You know, this type of franchise needed somebody that just knew that this was all absurd and just took it a step forward. Took it to the next level. But they just grabbed people that just wanted to play by the rules and just get their cash and get their money and walk out. So not to be an asshole and just scream out spoiler alert, but all you're gonna see is just bland sex, bland conversations, bland argument, and this random stalker guy that's just trying to make their life a living hell, even though... Dude, just fuck off. And this character is forced to have a relationship with Christian Grey, and it's forced to have a relationship with Anastasia Steele, being that he used to be the boss that would try to seduce his co-workers. The time's up movement, bitch. And we're expected to believe that this once book publisher is now a stalker, attempted killer who can infiltrate a company, hack through their systems, and do all this stuff by himself. And this all started as Twilight fan fiction. It's easy to say that this was the worst one out of the three because at least the first one had a nice little soundtrack. It was Oscar nominated for best song. The second one had a nice couple of songs. This one doesn't even have a standout song. The film ends with highlights from the first two flicks with a song from the first movie. It's like it even knows that this one doesn't have anything going for it, so they have to remind you that they had two other ones that, while still were shitty, were probably better than this shitty version. And yeah, it's gonna be in the top 10 list of worst movies to a lot of people. I already know Peter's gonna put it in the top 10 list, buddy. Still funny as hell though. Funny as hell for all the wrong reasons. So all in all, if you wanted to see something crazy sexy, I would just go back to any Paul Verhoeven movie. Watch Showgirls, damn it. That would probably be a lot sexier than this movie. But overall, 50 Shades Freed. We're glad that we're free from having to endure this franchise. This is over. Thank God, everybody. I'm gonna give this movie half a star out of 5. God. Damn! Well, once again, guys, thanks for watching. If you like what you see here, click like at the bottom. Go to our SoundCloud page for our more extensive reviews. This is Ray from LiveWire, and once again, thanks for watching.